everybody. Welcome to Jay Plays. Today I'm going to try something. I'm going to try playing Shadows of Brimstone one-handed because I'm holding the camera. If this doesn't work out, I'll switch over to the tripod. But anyway, that's super exciting to hear. But what I'm doing is I've had this idea for a series of videos called Shadows of Brimstone Max Grit. And in this series, I would bring in a female lawman. And I would have her teamed up with a male orphan to seek justice across the world of Shadows of Brimstone. But I wanted to start off kind of easy here. And I'm starting with one of the Frontier Town missions called Shootout in the Streets. In this mission, there are bandits in town and they're respawning, and we have to take them all down in order to win. But I'm going to alter the scenario a bit because I want to make a little story. So in this story, Maxine Rhodes, the sheriff of this, former sheriff of this town, is returning to town to deal with an incursion of bandits. So I've placed around in each building an exploration token. And if you've seen Shadows of Brimstone videos, such as those from Catweasel or D-Vang and other Brimstone video playthroughs, you'll notice that these exploration tokens are usually drawn when you find a new room in the mine. In this case, I've put them down for two things. One, if I find a clue, I'm going to draw one of these infamous bandit gangs and remove it from the game. This will show us... This represents Maxine finding out which gang is not involved in this town invasion. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to watch out for the word attack. And if I get an attack, I'm going to add D3 bandits to that room, assuming there are some that I can draw from. I only have 6 bandit models, as you can see. So if there are already 6 bandits in there... what I'm likely to do is give the closest D3 to Maxine an extra move and attack. But we'll see how that goes. I'm kind of winging this. The other side of this is that our good buddy Tyler, the orphan, is in one of these buildings captured by the bandits. So as we go along, Tyler's going to roll his strength roll to try to get loose. And he has to get as many successes in a roll as there are numbers on the darkness meter. So the first round, he's not going to try. But once the darkness gets to 1, I'll say the bandits are alerted, they're not watching him anymore, and he has a chance to succeed. Actually, you know what? Let's amend that. Sorry, I'm already making house rules. Let's make his escape check equal to the depth track check. So he rolls his strength and has to get 7, 8, or 9 plus. Or a 9 plus, then an 8 plus, and then a 7 plus, depending on where the darkness is that round. I mean, since I'm playing and Tyler isn't being played by another player, I don't mind him sitting out for a little while. But I hope he gets out free soon because Maxine's got her work cut out for her. Now, in the rules, you see bandits pop out every round in random locations. You can also see that the depth track is based on how many bandits I've killed. So I get 2 for each bandit I've killed. And when the Hold Back the Darkness roll, if the Hold Back the Darkness roll at the beginning of the round is higher than the current position of the posse marker, then I win. I just wipe out the rest of the bandits, and that's it. When the darkness marker works as normal, but when the blood spatter and growing dread spaces are hit, they have a different effect, and I'll show you what that means. If I reach a blood spatter space, all bandits on the rooftops immediately get a free attack, and if there are none on the rooftops, I immediately place a D3 new reinforcements onto random rooftops. Whenever the darkness reaches a growing dread space, Bandits immediately gain a new elite ability from their elite enemy record sheet. So, my plan was that the last bandit in the room with the last clue, I put three clues out there. The third clue will be guarded by some bandits. And what I was thinking about doing was putting in D3 bandits and giving one of them an extra elite ability. So we'll see what happens there. We might just get wiped out. And you can see, if we win, we get 50 XP and $100. I'm going to make it an extra 25 XP per clue token found. And if we fail, we lose D6 times 50. And... which is fine, because we don't have any money. But if we lose, we can't go to town after this, and I'll make a separate video going to town. Anyway, we'll see how this goes. I'm kind of creating my own scenario on the fly, and I'll walk you through how the game plays as I go. If you want to know more about how the game plays, there are better instructional videos than this on the internet. Just look for Cat Weasel, or Doug Herring, or D-Vang, or any of those guys. The Outlaw Josie Wales is a really good series. That's been going on forever. So check those out, and hopefully this goes well, but we'll see. Taking a look at Maxine here. She's a lawman. She has laying down the law once per attack. She can reroll one to hit roll. No doubt I'll forget that. She's got her stats here. I won't go into them until they're needed. She has a peacekeeper pistol, which gives her a little bit of a bonus to shots. Her sheriff badge gives us bonus shots or combat once per adventure. Her weathered hat lets her reroll a single defense roll once per turn. And strong leadership lets her spend grit to heal one health and one sanity from yourself and every other hero on the tile and gain experience for that. She's got the lantern, but she doesn't need it. And here's Tyler. He's young. He can't dual wield guns, but he does heal one wound or sanity at the beginning of each turn, unless he's knocked out. He also goes before enemies at his initiative level and automatically passes all escape tests. Usually, if you're tied with an enemy for initiative, the enemies go first. On a mission, he starts with an orphan mission, which is find the killer in this case. So he gets plus one max grit, so he can have up to three grit at start. He needs four discoveries, which I'm not going to make any discoveries in this particular episode. But if he manages to find four discoveries, he'll start each adventure with an extra grit. And if I'm doing videos long enough that he finds all these discoveries, I'll run an extra mission in which he and Maxine take on the killer themselves. He has a ribbon, plus one agility. At the end of each adventure, he can remove one corruption. He has a need for vengeance, so he starts with an extra revive token. And he has a regular pistol. So I'm going to get a couple more things out, and we'll be ready to play. So, every round of Shadows of Brimstone begins with the Hold Back the Darkness roll. For that, you roll two dice, and hope to get more than this number right here on the dice combined. So, we got a five, so we're good. Now, in order of initiative, things activate. The bandits are going to activate first. They have initiative 5. And they have the ability Shootout. They prefer ranged attacks over melee. They move and target using shootout markers with the following procedure. So they're going to move into range with me. They're all going to target Maxine there. They're going to move it to the shortest distance to be within range in LOS, and they're going to make ranged attacks. If they're in melee, they like to retreat. So, their initiative is 5. They have bandit pistols. Range of 2 hit rolls of 6 cost 3 hits each. They hit on 5 plus in range or 4 plus in melee. Combat 2, damage 2, defense 3, health 3, and there's some elite abilities. The range on their weapon is 6. So they want to be within 6 squares of her. And they're all going to be targeting her, so putting some shoot out targets on her. And now they're going to move. They have a movement of 6, so they're all just going to move 3. He's going to get in range of cover. Like that. So I'm pretending that these barrels and troughs and stuff are cover. When it comes to that, I will look cover up in the book and find out what it does. I believe it gives you temporary armor, I just don't know how much it is. So, that's it for their move, I believe. They can't shoot. Actually, let me look at the rules and see. It's been a little while since I played this, so I'm going to look at the rules for the AI and see what happens. Alright, so I looked up cover and I looked up enemy actions. Basically, they get to move and attack every round. There's nobody in range, so they don't move any further. Cover means that you roll a d6, and on a 4, 5, or 6, you ignore the shot completely if they hit, so that's pretty awesome. So now we're on initiative 4. The orphan would go first, but Tyler's not going to roll for this round. And so now we're going to have Maxine go. Maxine has a move. I totally forgot. All heroes roll to move, so let's see what she rolls. She rolled a 4, so she can move 4 spaces. Now her gun has a range of 6. So we know that she can hit somebody from here. But I'm not certain that she wants to just stand out in the open. So I think she's going to go over here. Like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. That gives her some cover. I put this poker chip under her to help differentiate her from Tyler, because their models look kind of similar from this distance. But there she is. Alright, so there's nobody she can shoot at. And you can't search in this particular map, so that's it for her round. And the orphan's not going. So that's the end of the round. Let's hold back the darkness. That's 8, so yep. That did it. Actually, I rolled a 5 in the previous one, and that did not hold it back. So we're going to move the darkness up 1. So the orphan's roll to escape is based on the darkness track. No, it's based on the player track. So we'll reverse these. I'm sorry, I'm making up rules right now. We'll reverse these. So while the player's in here, the orphan needs a 9+ on strength check to get loose, or 2 dice to get loose. Here an 8 and here a 7. We'll reverse the numbers for them. But this number here is important for determining how we win. So I'm not going to reverse the spots. Again, the perils of making up a scenario as you go. Now, she could go and check into these rooms, and she may want to do that while these bandits are out. But that's it. So the bandits are going to go now. The bandits have a move of 6. So this guy's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Try to get some cover. This guy's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Out in the open. And this guy's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. More cover. So they're spreading out. Now, can this guy take a shot? Range of 6. Yes, he can, but he will have cover. So now you get to see how combat works. In combat, these guys are going to roll a number equal to the shots on their pistols, because they're making a range attack. So I grab 3 dice. And they have to roll their range to hit. So any die that is a 5+ is going to count as a success for them. And they got a 6. He got a 6. So when they hit, they're going to do that amount of damage there. But since he rolled a 6, it's going to cause 3 hits. So 3 hits of 2. So what happens is anything that hits I get a defense roll on. And Lawman's defense roll is 4+. So I roll the number of dice equal to the number of hits and hope for a 4+. And I blocked none of them. So I just took 6 of my 12 damage. Ouch. That was rough. Alright, so that's it for them. And now they're going to go. The orphan is going to go first. He's going to roll 2 dice. And he escaped. So, in the first round, Tyler escaped. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to roll a die, a D8, because there's 8 buildings, and I'm going to find out what building Tyler is in. He's in building 2. So here's Tyler. Right there. So that worked out pretty well, but that's going to be his whole turn. And now it's Maxine's turn. Now we know Maxine can attack that guy because they both have range 6. But she still is going to roll to move and get to 4. So I'm wondering if it might not be better for her to go in and try to check this clue. So let's do that. And for her action, she'll check the clue. And it is a clue. All right. So only one of the guys can see her now. So let's figure out which of these bandit gangs it's going to be. Or it's not going to be. So the bandits behind this attack are not El Tejon's Desperados. And that's going to give us an extra 25 bucks or maybe 10 experience points. Well, we give her 10 experience points for that. I have these cool experience cards here. And we'll stack them up on the side. But that's the end of her turn. And now she's in a door, which gives her cover. But she can still be shot. And that's the end of the round. Let's hold back the darkness. We failed to hold back the darkness. Now we're on a blood spot. And the blood spot means that all bandits on rooftops immediately get a free attack. So there are no bandits on the rooftops. So we're going to roll a d3. That's one bandit on a rooftop, and he's going to go to a random rooftop. 4. So we've got a bandit on the roof of that building there. The bandits on the roof have a range of 12. 2 shots and 4 damage, so they're tough. And there are rules for hitting them that I may have to look up once we get into range. Let's see. Bandits on rooftops. They activate and make shooting attacks as a group before bandits on the ground. When an enemy on a rooftop is killed by a hero, roll a d6. On a roll of a 1, 2, or 3, the enemy falls from the rooftop screaming. And their hero may recover 1 grit. Whenever one takes 1 or more wounds from an attack, roll a d6. On the roll of 1, 2, or 3, the hero falls from the rooftop. So there's that. A hero starting activation inside a building may give up his movement to move up to the rooftop. Alright, so that wasn't a bad round, I guess. It's back to the bandits again. This guy doesn't have anybody he can see. I guess he can move there and see her. So let's see. 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12. Not enough. She's safe from the sniper. This guy, however, is at max range from her. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And these guys are going to try to get into max range of one of the characters. This guy's going to go 1. Like that. He's going to shoot in at the orphan. The orphan's going to get cover. And this guy is going to go there. Now, allies don't block. Two, three, four, six. I don't remember if allies block line of sight, so I will check that in a bit. But let's see what happens with these attacks. These bandits get three shots. He can't see her, but he can. So let's take his shots first. No hits, because they hit on 5+. And then this one on Tyler. Two hits. One of them is a 6. So now we're going to roll cover for Tyler. Any 4+ is not going to... And cover breaks both of those hits down so that nothing happened. Now Tyler goes before guys on a tied initiative, so he's going to go first. He has a pistol with a range of 6 and 2 shots. So he's going to just move here and shoot this guy. 2 shots. I forgot to roll to see if any bandits come into play. They did. One did, so let's see where he comes from. And he's going to come from entry point C. So he's over here. I forgot that I need to do that every round. Alright, so Tyler is going to shoot this guy. He's got a 2 and a 4. He hits on 4+. In range, so that's 1 damage. Now players roll their damage. He rolled 5 damage. The bandit has 3 defense, so 2 damage went through. So he's almost dead. And now we're on Maxine's turn. Maxine is going to run into this room and see what that is. But let's make sure she can get there by rolling. Now she rolled a 1. If she rolls a 1, she gets a free grit point. But she can only move 1. So I think she might stay there and hang on to the cover and take a shot at the guy who shot at her. She gets 3 shots because of her peacekeeper pistol. And... not a good roll. She's going to use that grit she just got. You can use them to re-roll dice. Still not a great roll. She has 1 hit. Let's see how much damage she can do. If she can roll a 6, she'll kill him. She rolled a 2, which is not enough. Alright, that's it for our heroes and our villains. So let's roll for holding back the darkness. We got a 6. It's not enough. Darkness meter's coming up pretty quick. Let's roll to see if more bandits show up. We got 2 bandits that show up, but they there's not enough. And he shows up into 2. 2 is entry point D, which is back here. Okay. So now the bandits are going to go first, and there's a crap ton of bandits. So they're going to move. This guy's going to come and flesh her out. He doesn't want to be that close to her. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He's going to move back here. He's going to move... there. The rooftop guy is going to stay where he is. This would not be a bad time to look up the line of sight rule for enemies. And I'll do it right here, and I can cut it if I need to. Line of sight for ranged attacks. You must be able to draw a straight line from the center of the hero's space to the center of target space without crossing a wall. Nothing else affects line of sight. That's easy enough. Okay, so these guys can all shoot. He's going to go stand right here. Oh, wait, he was back there for a reason. All right, so still nobody in range for the sniper. Two, three, four, five, six. This guy is not in range, so we got two shots on her, one shot on him. So for the two shots on the marshal, see here, come on, I don't need any more damage on the marshal. Oh my god, that's three shots on the marshal, one of which was a crit. So I'm going to roll the crit separately. It was not blocked. And then the two regular hits were both blocked by cover. That is awesome. So the crit is going to be three hits. So we're going to roll defense for that. She needs a 4+. She blocked one of those, so she took another 4 damage. She's almost dead, folks. She's almost KO'd. And that was one of the two shots on her. Here comes the other one. One hit, but it was a crit. Let's roll for the cover. Miss. She blocked one of two. She went down. She went down. Now she's going to grit that last one. Okay, she blocked one. She still got two hit points and went down. Okay, so she is knocked out. Let me see if I can get a KO token here. So this isn't going as planned. She can get back up because each of these buildings is considered a tile. So we should have a certain number of revive tokens. And in my infinite lack of preparation, I haven't looked up how many we get. So let's see. We get one revive token. And we're already using it. Let's see if I can find it in the box. Which I cannot, but since we're using it right now anyway, it doesn't matter, so she's going to use her revive token. Her revive token lets her stand right back up with no damage and no sanity loss. And sanity wouldn't be a big problem in this particular game because these guys don't cause any. But that's it. And then we have one attack from this guy against the orphan. And he hit once. Let's see if it's blocked by the door. It is blocked by the door. So Tyler has all kinds of luck, this guy. It is now Tyler's turn, so he's going to take a shot at this guy and hopefully kill him. Yeah. Okay, so he rolled two hits. That six is a crit, so it ignores defense. Now, in this game, you don't have to target the guy. You don't have to choose what your targets are until after you roll hits. And he could distribute hits against the guys that he can see. So pretend if he could see these two, he could give the hits out like that. But he can only see him, so both of them are going to go to him. So we only need one more damage to kill him. It ignores defense. I rolled two, and he died. So that means we get to move the hero version of the death track that way. So if we manage to roll a 14 on a holding back the darkness roll, we'll be good. Chances of that are minimal at best, considering it's impossible. He forgot to roll for movement. He didn't move, but he needs to roll to see if he gets grit, but she didn't. So here comes Maxine. She's going to roll to move. She got a 3. She wants to get out of dodge, so to speak. So she's going to go 1, 2, 3. No, she wants to go in the building. 1, 2, 3. And it's an attack. So apparently there was a guy in there. There were some dudes in there. Sleeping on this little bed here. And he didn't wake up until all the shooting started. Let's put this over here. So now he's there. And Maxine is going to blast him in the face, because that's what you do. She got 1 hit. If she rolls a 6, that's all she needs. If she rolled a 3, that's not enough. She can re-roll a 2-hit roll once. Let's do that. It's cheating a bit to do it after damage, but I just remembered she can do it. So that's much better. She just hit 3 times. The crit could kill him outright. Does not. So that's 1 damage. Second hit, doesn't do any damage. Third hit, does no damage. Maxine really, really is not doing well. You suck, Maxine. Some law person you are. So that's not good. She's going to get shot in the face on her next turn. Speaking of which, let's hold back that darkness. We failed again. So now we're on 3. This is not going well. I'm rolling low when it counts. So now the bandits go. Bandits shoot Maxine in the face. She has no cover. 2 hits. Maxine is going to dodge those 2 hits. She dodges 1 hit, so she takes 2 damage. That's not bad. I forgot to move these guys, so he would have moved to here, I guess, to get out of being adjacent from her. Well, let's see, a 4 and a 4, 5 or 6. He would have moved here to retreat, to get away from her. No, he would have gone here. Then he took the shot. This guy would have moved and gone here, take a shot. This guy probably would have gone 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to get here, to shoot at him. And this guy would go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This guy goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this guy stays up there. He has no targets. So we've got another shot on Maxine. And we got 2 shots on Tyler. Another 6 against Maxine. And no... Oh, there is cover on that one. And she blocked it. That's awesome. That was from the guy outside. And the guy inside hits once. No, they need a 5 plus to hit, so he blocked. He missed completely, even at that distance. Now we've got 2 shots on the orphan, and now I'm going to roll them all at the same time. 3 sixes? That's ridiculous. All right, so let's see if he blocks any of these with the cover. He blocked 1 from the cover. Now let's see. He's got to roll 6 defense dice, and he dodges on 4s. All right, he just took 6 damage. Not good. He only has 8 health. But he does have an extra revive token because of this Need for Vengeance ability, so he gets 1 as well. No bueno. No bueno. All right, so... It's his turn. He can shoot any of these bandits. He's going to shoot the one in... let's see where he... see how far he can move. I always forget that in this game. He can go 2. Okay, so... He's going to get in here. And he's going to shoot at this guy. Maybe they can make their way out of this room. Yeah, two crits. All right, Tyler is kind of the man, or I guess he will be one day. That's two crits, so this guy doesn't get any defense. That's six total damage. He died. Which gives us another two spaces on the track. So every time we kill one of these guys, also, we're getting experience points. So Tyler should have 30 experience points now. But I think what I'm going to do is put all the experience points in a pool. And then divide them up evenly, because who cares? So, she's only being targeted by one, he's being targeted by two, and it's Maxine's turn. Maxine is going to roll dice against that guy outside there. She's hoping to clear up an escape path out that back door. She hit once. She has no... Oh, let's see what she gets for movement. So, five. She wants to check some more of these buildings, so I think she's going to go... She's going to go out this way. Now, can she still shoot that guy? No, she can't, but he can't shoot her either. She can, however, shoot none of those guys. So, that's it for her. And that's it for our round. So let's hold back the darkness again. Now we could technically roll a 12. We won't. We rolled a 5. We have yet to hold back the darkness successfully. D3 bandits are going to appear on rooftops because of the blood spatter. So one appears on the rooftop of building 3. So we got a rooftop bandit up there too. Now he can see. He's close enough that he can see stuff. So we got a problem coming up here, you guys. Now we're going to roll D3 bandits. Two bandits. Now we don't have enough bandits to place them, so they go up twice. And now they have an elite ability because of the growing dread space. Elite ability number 6. Their range to hit is now 4+. So I'm going to go grab a number 6 tile and put it on there. That indicates that their elite ability is number 6. Not good, not good. We've held back the darkness, or failed to do so, and now it is time for the bandits to go. The bandits on the roof go first. They can't see anybody, so that's fine. Now we'll start with this guy. He's going to go to the furthest spot where he can see his target, and these guys will do that as well. They can't see him from out here, so they have to go there. There. So 3 shots against the orphan and 1 shot against Lady. Now, he's not knocked out, so he gets to heal a wound, but I have a feeling he's not going to be doing so hot after this episode, or after this round. So start here, see what happens. That's 1 hit. He's going to try to dodge it. And he did. Second guy. No hits. Third guy. No hits. Wow, the orphan is standing up to all of this. Look at that. He's just, like, faced off against 3 angry bandits. And he's surviving. This is badass. So now this one on Maxine. Oh my god, why am I rolling 6s against her? Alright, so here's this. This is her defense roll. So this is actually really good. She blocked all of it. She blocked all of it. She just got shot right in the face and survived. I think things might be turning around for her, and I'm gonna Knock on wood. All right, so let's see what we got here. Okay, so good old, you know what? I think she's going to use the sheriff badge now to give +2 shots to both her and to Tyler. So Tyler's going to roll 4 dice for this attack. He missed, so he's going to roll. He's going to use a grit to re-roll these 3. Put this 5 up here. Yep, that sucked. All right, so he's hitting once for... He's going to put it on, I guess, this guy here. For 6 damage, that kills him. Kills him outright. That's awesome. And we go 2 spaces here. Awesome, well done. Well done, Tyler. And now Maxine has 5 dice against that one guy. And she rolled 2 crits and a 5. So 1 crit ought to do it. Yep. That's it. It's another 2. So it looks like things are starting to turn around for us. Because our guys have found their talent in shooting things. I'll just get rid of some of these shootout tokens here. Now would be a time for them to run off and try to find some of these clue tokens, I think. But let's hold back the darkness. Holy crap, you guys, we did it! We got an 8. We needed 8 plus. So we got an 8. We held back that darkness. Now let's see if some bandits appear. We get 1 bandit. On the 3. So the 3 is entry point A, which is over here. So pretty far. Alright, now the bandits go first. These guys. So, my camera just died. I think I hit a max limit of the length of a video on my camera. So, please excuse the hiccups. I believe I put everything back the way they were. Not much happened. We rolled to hold back the darkness. That guy showed up, and then I started moving these guys. So, bandits. These guys are going to bug off because they're afraid of the orphan. And they're just going to run out there. They can still see him through that door, but he'll get cover. This guy goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He can see Maxine. These guys still can't see anybody, so that's fine. We have 1 attack on Maxine and 2 on Tyler. So let's see. For Maxine, we have 1, 6. She has cover. Blocked. For Tyler, rolling 6 dice for the 2 3-die attacks at once. With 6, a 5, and a 4. Tyler has cover. This is for the 6. Not blocked. For the 5 and the 4, 1 blocked. So he's taking 4 total hits that he needs to dodge. And he needs a 4+. So he dodged 1. So he took 6 damage and went unconscious. That's going to cost him his revive token. So now we've got that. We have no revive tokens left. Not good. Alright, so I think that Tyler wants to bug out as well. So let's see how much he rolls first. 5 steps. So, does he want to get over to where she is? You know what? He's just going to move to the door and try to kill one of these guys. Alright, so he's going to take 2 shots. 1 hit. And that'll be on this guy. Come on, do some damage. Yes, he did 2 damage. 5 minus 3 for their defense. 2 damage. So that is that's him almost dead. And now we're to Maxine. Now Maxine could come out and plug that guy. Let's find out what... She's got 5 movement as well. Can she get here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. She can get over here. And then take a shot at this guy. Or she can help Tyler out. That might be the best way to go. Sorry about that. Just kind of thinking this through a little bit. She wants to get these exploration tokens, but if she gets an attack and spawns some more bandits, we could be in trouble. Well, the only guy she can see from here is this guy, so she's going to take a shot at him. Oh, nice. That's 2 hits. Sweet. So this is both going to go on him. So this one doesn't do any damage, and this one does 2. So 2 more wounds on that guy. And that's the end of the round, so let's hold back the darkness. Now, if we get an 8+, which is enough to hold back the darkness, we also... no longer have any more bandit spawns. So, we got a 9. We're done with the bandits. So, this is all the bandits. Once we kill these guys out, we've cleared the town. But we still want to get these exploration tokens, I think. So, let's see what happens. The bandits go first. This guy's going to retreat. And this guy is also going to retreat back to here. And I just forgot that this guy is targeting her. This guy Oh, we need to see if the last guy pops out. He does, and he goes to 5. And 5 means a random building rooftop. So, building 3 is rooftop. So, we got 2 guys up here. Alright, so there's apparently something being hidden in that room. We may or may not have to deal with it, but we do have to go up there and kill those guys. So, let's see. So, those can't shoot anything. So, we got 2 shots on the orphan and 1 shot on Maxine. Tyler is going to take 1 hit, but it's a 3, or 6. So cover. Did not save it. And defense. Block 2 of them, so he only takes 2 damage. Alright, and Maxine takes 1 hit and dodges it. So that was good for them. So, we start with Tyler, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, still in range. He's going to shoot at the guy he shot at last time and hopefully get a hit. Well, first he's going to roll to move. Got a 4. Now, he could move out of there. He would not be able to get into that building. He needs to get in there in order to get upstairs. So, I think he's just going to take a shot at this guy here. Another crit. Good boy, Tyler. A 1 will kill him, but a 3 will definitely kill him. That's good. Now, we don't need to deal with the depth track anymore, but we will put this down. Because I believe I've lost track of how many bandits we've killed, which should be 2, 4. We've moved this... 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10 times. So we've killed 5 bandits. And we have 40, so 15 per bandit, 5 bandits, we should have 60 more experience points. Which, there's 50 and 10, so 60. Alright, not a bad round for the Boy Wonder. And now Maxine's going to take her shot. Let's see what she rolls to move, though. 3. Yeah, she's not getting anywhere useful with a 3. So she's going to take a shot at Mr. Bozo Head there. 2 crits! Awesome! Alright, so crit number 1. Kills him. And she can hit this guy too. So crit number 2 does 1 damage. So that was a really good round for her. One, two, three, four. Nicely done. Finally, you showed up. Maxine is here to play. All right, that's the end of the round. We're going to hold back the darkness. We succeed in doing so. I don't know if there are depth events in this. I don't know why there would be, because we're in a town. Depth events usually are mine things, but who knows, maybe there's a town depth event chart that I'm ignoring. But whatever, it's my first game in a long time, my first video, so get over it. Alright, so that's the end of the round. We've already done Hold Back the Darkness. Let's see where the... there's no new bandits coming out, so that's good too. Now the bandits are going to shoot at us. This guy was targeting the Boy Wonder. And he's the only bandit on the ground left. So he's going to take a shot at the Boy Wonder again. He hits on 4+. He hit twice and one's a 6. Here's the cover for the 6. Not blocked. And the cover for the 5. Not blocked. So he's going to take 4 hits. And he's going to do 4 damage, or 4 defense rolls. He blocked 3 of the 4. That's awesome. Well done, son. 2 more wounds on him for that 1 hit that he took, but that's not bad. Okay, so Boy Wonder is going 5 spaces. Now he can get into this building with 5. So I think he's going to leave this guy to the lawman and just go. No, he can't get in there with 5 either. Nope. Because as soon as he steps out here, these guys can all see him. One, two, three, four, five. Whew, that's tough. We got 3 snipers on that building ready to kill an orphan. He's going to stay where he is and take a shot at that guy right there. See if he can kill him. Yeah. Okay, so the 6, he needs a 2 or better to kill him. He got a 3, so that guy died. Boom. And we put that there. And we've got another 30 experience because I forgot to grab the one for the one we killed before. Alright, now Maxine is clear. She can move 3. She's going to get out there into the street. 1, 2, 3. Maybe she's going to be free and clear of the snipers. That's it. Okay, so we held back the darkness for 9. 9 plus. The snipers. They can see her. These 2 can. So 2 sniper shots. These are shots 2, damage 4. So, the first guy, I'm just going to roll 4 dice. They don't get a crit. Or I guess they would, because they're still bandits. Alright. Yeah, that's 3 hits. So she's going to dodge 3 hits and hopefully not take 4 shots in the face. She took 2. So that's 8 damage. And she went down.
From one sniper hit.
One sniper shot. Where'd that go? Okay. Now, there are currently no bandits on her tile because each house or each building interior is considered a tile and the streets are considered a tile, and these guys are on top of the building. So, this is going to be tough. This is going to be really tough. If they both get wiped out, then we go right into the next mission. So, let's see what happens. That's it for the round, isn't it? It's possible that I missed the orphan's move, but I don't know. Giant brain fart. Let's see what happens. We'll do a hold back the darkness roll. Yep, we got one. 9. Bandits go. They can't see. Oh no, that was a bandit shooting at her. So it's not a new round. It's this guy. The orphan gets to go now. Sorry about that, guys. All right, so he can go 3. He needs to get over there. He's going to heal a wound at the beginning of his turn, like he's supposed to have been doing all this time. He can't just run 3 and get up there. And he has no grit. All right, so he's going to... There's no way to get that building without taking a bunch of shots, so I think this one might be lost, but let's find out. 1, 2, 3. That's the best he can do. And then on her turn, she's going to revive, but she's going to get an injury. Let's see, where's that injury chart? Alright, so here's the injury chart. She gets 2d6 health and/or sanity back. So that's 6 health back, so she would have 6 left. Boom. And now she gets an injury. She rolls 2d6. She rolled a 7, so she gets a concussion. Until the start of the adventure, you are -1 initiative and roll 1 less die on all skill tests. So that's not too bad. And it goes away on its own, so that's good. Also, there's my floor. So, she's back up. And I believe that's probably her whole turn. No, I don't think it is. I'm going to say it isn't because she needs to get inside the door. 1, 2, 3. She's in there, and her action will be to overturn that, and it's nothing. I'm ignoring encounter reactions. It's top of the round. I don't know what that was, so I'm going to re-roll that. That's an 8. That is not enough to hold back the darkness, so the darkness goes here. And now the bad guys go. So they can all 3 see him down there, so he's going to get a lot of shots at him. 6 shots, to be precise. All damage 4. So he only took 3. That's good. 1 is a 6. This counts as 3 hits. So 5 dodge rolls here. And he dodged all but 1. Awesome. He still took 4 damage. So he's at 7 of his 8. But At least he survived, and he'll be able to get into that building. So, see what he gets to roll for movement? He rolls a 5. Can he get in? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Didn't get inside the building. Neither one of them can see him in there. And now he can get up there. But for his action, he's going to flip this exploration token. And there's an attack inside the building. There's two bandits in there just partying in the bar. That's pretty harsh. I think he's gonna die. Alright, and there's Maxine. She knows that the little kid is in there risking his life, so let's see. Does she burn tail to get to him? The answer is no. She has 2 movement there. She can't shoot at anybody. And that's the end of the round. Darkness holding. Missed. There we go. So we went hit a blood spatter, but there's no more bandits arriving. Bandits are going. Can they see her now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes, that's going to be 2 shots at her. And 2 shots at him. Now these 2 guys are going to bug out a little bit. They need to get the furthest away that they can still shoot him. He's going to get cover, but there we go. So we got 2 sniper shots on Max, and only 2 hit. 1 is a crit, though. She doesn't get any cover, so she's got to block 4 hits. She blocked 1 hit. So she just took 12 damage and went down again. These bandits are insane. They're damn rooftop bandits. So she's down again. She's going to take another injury. And now I've got 2 shots on the kid. And these are ground bandits, so they get 3 shots each. 3 hits. One of them is a 6, but he's got cover. So let's roll the 6 for cover. Not blocked. And then the 5 and the 4 for cover. 1 is blocked. So he's taking 4 hits and defending against them. He blocked 2 of them. So he's going to take 4 damage and get knocked out. And I think if they're both knocked out, we lose. So the bandits have taken this town, unfortunately, and we don't even know which team of bandits is behind it. So the next game we have to try to find a way to escape from the bandits and figure out who it is that took over the town and who it is that killed Tyler's parents. But that's going to be for another time. Thank you for tuning in. Sorry about any rules mistakes. And this is a bit of a Shadows of Brimstone light, because we're not discovering new rooms. We're not doing events. This is just the first shootout encounter in the Frontier Town expansion. And I just wanted to get an intro to the game and get these 2 characters together, Max and Tyler. And I would love to do more of these Shadows of Brimstone videos and do an evolving story. You'll have to bear with me. I'm kind of trying to make up scenarios on the fly. I'm kind of a writer and game designer by trade, so I'm coming up with them on the fly, so I wish I could playtest them before I put them on video, but that's what you get. So if you liked any of these scenarios that I put on these videos, let me know, and I'll try and work up a document for them. In the meantime, hopefully this puts together a pretty good story for you to enjoy. And thanks for watching.